did the Intimidator.
Twice.
Intimidator 305. Very much so still alive.
Why are y'all overrated?
Okay,
yeah, I was gonna say, for those of you who are like, this is the best roller coaster in the world, this is the most intense roller coaster in the world, oh my god.
Wrong.
Alright, I made several predictions about this. The amount of times I have bullied, she doesn't know about this, but the amount of times I have bullied this ride about being the most overrated thing ever, because I was like, there's no way this thing is the best thing ever. It isn't. At the Goliath at Magic Mountain is more intense than this thing. Seriously, you don't even gray out on it. I mean, I get that they did reprofile the first turn and stuff.
See, that last part is Goliath what? Is more intense.
Goliath is more intense.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Not that it's a good ride. Goliath still sucks, but this button. But yeah, that was kind of trash. I mean, it was fun. It was all right, but Maverick was better than that.
Maverick.
I don't know what you guys are saying. Yeah, I want more Maverick.
Me too.
Maverick was such a good ride. But yeah, this thing was kind of trash.
Well, we are here at King's Dominion.
Well,
and
yeah, I didn't even record the intro before immediately talking about I-305. Because as you guys know, I have spent a lot of time on this channel bullying the crap out of I-305, throwing shade at it in any possible way. And now that I have finally had the opportunity to ride it, I can safely say that it is the most overrated roller coaster that I have ridden, above Ghost Rider. So, I don't know what you guys are saying about this coaster. Y'all are like, oh yeah, this is easily the most intense roller coaster ever.
Drag him.
What?
Drag him.
Drag him?
I'm telling them to drag you.
Oh, no, no, but yeah, no, that was not, you don't even gray out on it. I rode, the first ride was more towards the middle, so I guess I was like, okay, well maybe we try front or back, it'll be better. We tried back row, very back, and it, nope. The drop is fun, so I guess tomorrow, since I'll be here tomorrow again, I'll try the front row for sure.
I think the most fun part of that ride was the lift.
The lift hill is so relaxing, and the drop is really good. And then the brake run too, because you get to sit there and do nothing, which is basically what the ride does anyways. So anyways, we're gonna do more stuff here. I-305 is overrated.
In the natural habitats, we find Sister dining away underneath a blue umbrella.
Blue.
Welp, I just rode Anaconda right there, and it was fun. My sister didn't ride it because she doesn't like Viper at Magic Mountain, and it was super jank. Anyways, time to do RMC Guy food review with Sister Edition. Oh. Sister review, food review.
Chicken Shack.
So review.
Might actually be better than Chick-fil-A.
What is it?
It is a tender, English. Tender sandwich.
Mmm.
With fries, Mr. Squidward.
With fries.
I made this gourmet edition and poured the ranch on my sandwich.
Ooh, gourmet. But yeah, I-305, Anaconda. It was fun. I would say it's better than Demon at CGA, but not as good as Canyon Blaster. I think those are the two most comparable aero loopers. Don't even ask me about Viper. It's nowhere near as good as Viper. But yeah, that's Anaconda.
Okie dokie, it is time to ride Twisted Timmy. Timmy the ride.
Tim.
Yes, here it goes down its epic drop.
Are you ready for Timmy?
Black.
Great.
Upside down.
We just rode Timmy, Twisted Little Timbers. Steve.
And yeah, it feels literally exactly like Steel Vengeance's second half, everything that happens after the mid-course. It's very aggressive. It was way more aggressive than I expected. And yeah, tons of ejector, really good RMC. I wouldn't say it's better than Twisted Colossus, but it's definitely better than Joker at Discovery Kingdom. Also definitely better than Jersey Double Coaster. That was really aggressive. So now we're gonna ride, well that's a store, but we're gonna go ride Grizzly. We're gonna ride the store. We're gonna ride the merch. Yeah, best ride in the park right here.
Okay, we just did Not the Beast at Not King's Island.
Beast was definitely better.
Oh yeah, easily, but like, yeah.
I would say that this Grizzly is definitely better than the other Grizzly I've been on, which was the one at California's Great America. It was all right. It didn't do too much. It was fun. Yeah. But Beast was definitely better.
Yep.
Yes. More forceful than Intimidator 305.
Well, it's called Dominator.
It's, yeah. We have Dominator and Intimidator. This is the best thing ever. Okay, that was epic.
Sorry, okay, we're here live in the woods. What we're gonna do, we're gonna do sneak attack on our parents. Okay, we found them in their natural habitat. Okay, you see over there, we see another wild herd. These fat Americans grilling. And then over here, we just got these two individuals. I think they're mates. Let's find out. Let's get a little closer.
He doesn't see it.
Oh my god. Well, that was interesting. We're still at King's Dominion, I promise. Oh. Just gonna stare at the camera the whole time?
Would you like a tour, sir?
Oh, yes, we would like a tour.
Cabin. King's Dominion cabin. First you have gourmet stairs.
Gourmet stairs.
Yes. Entrance. See? Living area. First TV. TV number one. This is very important later on. You'll see. Okay, this is probably the area you're gonna hog for your computer stuff. Bathroom number one. If you go in there, we got a sink. Why is the drain in the middle like that? Anyway, sink. Toilet paper. Oh. Toilet paper. Toilet. Door for privacy. Optional.
Toilet door for privacy.
Door for optional privacy. Some people just like doing it out in the open. bathroom number two. Same thing. You got a weird drain in the middle. You got toilet and toilet paper right there. And the door if you want. I don't know, bro. Master bedroom. Not for children. Creepy things on the wall. TV number two. Now we're gonna go
break
up.
It.
Uncomfortably narrow stairs into the loft.
Mm-hmm. Okay, calm down.
Loft number one. TV number three. If you look that way, you got loft number two. TV number four. Luxury. If you want to go over that way, you can look right into the living room. It's kind of haunted. We got Stanley right there. He keeps the demons out. Very essential. Anyway, this has been our cabin tour. Have a good day.
When you come to King's Dominion, you should totally come here because this place is epic. Okay, bye.
Well, I didn't know King's Dominion was also a kindergarten class. We're being walked over to...
We are being escorted because we cannot walk ourselves.
We're literally being escorted. I assume he's just taking us to Twisted Timbers. I assume that's where everyone is going, as Twisted Timbers is easily the best coaster here. But yes, welcome to day two at King's Dominion, where we are casually walking.
Oh, we're at the water park.
We are not at the water park. We are casually walking to Twisted Timbers. Yay.
First ride of the day on Twisted Timbers. Yay, Mini Steve. Woohoo.
This ride's epic. Okay, well, this thing kind of sucked. This was probably the least aggressive wild mouse I've ever ridden. It really just didn't, like, the laterals just didn't even exist. It's a wild mouse. You expect it to just have countless laterals. But yeah, no, this one didn't. This one kind of sucked. Oh well, I did it for the credit. Yay. Okay, Racer was fun. Now it's time for Backlot Sun Coaster. I did the one at King's Island, and the special effects were working, but I don't think the special effects on this one are working, so, oh well. I'm still gonna ride it anyways, because yay. Rode Intimidator 305 again in the front row. It's a lot hotter. It felt like it was running faster. Yeah, it was all right. It was definitely a lot more intense this time than the last time. Okay, not a lot, but the first turn actually made me gray out this time. So yeah, other than that, it's like, it's just fun. I don't know, it's a little overrated. Sorry to disappoint, but my opinion really hasn't changed. But yeah, Intimidator 305, it's basically the same. It's fun, but it's overrated. Okay, that's pretty much it. Here, you can just enjoy the rest of this little bit of footage here as they go and disappointment as this thing hits the brakes because I-305 is overrated. Sorry, Chaos, and the rest of you who are I-305 lovers. Okay, that's it.
That is going to conclude this King's Dominion vlog. It has been a great 2 days here at the park. Today was definitely a better day than yesterday in terms of rides, just because I was here for longer. Also, the weather was definitely a lot nicer. So I got 8 rides on Intimidator 305 overall, and my opinions on it don't exactly change. Didn't exactly change, I mean. But yeah, anyways, fun little park. I-305 is overrated. Twisted Timbers is definitely the best ride of the park. But yeah, I will see you guys in the next vlog, where I'll be at Busch Gardens Williamsburg in Williamsburg, Virginia. But yeah, that is King's Dominion. And there's some epic music playing as I depart. Goodbye.